Henry Ruggs was involved in a car crash, thus making him no longer a member of the Raiders. Let's take a look at this story. Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to the Outside Scoop. For this video, we'll talk about everything you need to know about the Henry Ruggs car crash incident. But before anything else, please go ahead and leave a like on the video. Also, don't forget to subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you never miss out on any future content we'll produce for you guys. Without any further ado, let's go ahead and hop right on to the video. Wide receiver Henry Ruggs III of the Las Vegas Raiders has involved himself in a two-vehicle collision earlier just weeks ago. He and a female passenger were brought to a hospital and treated for non-life-threatening injuries, while the driver of the other car was killed. Ruggs' Chevrolet Corvette collided with the back of a Toyota RAV4, which subsequently caught fire, according to a preliminary investigation by the Las Vegas Metro Police Department. The corpse of a lady was recovered inside the Toyota, and authorities claim Ruggs' blood alcohol level was above the legal limit, and he was speeding before the incident. The Raiders released a statement saying, "We are devastated by the loss of life, and our thoughts and prayers go out to the victim's family. Here's what we know at the moment. Ruggs showed symptoms of impairment after the collision, according to Las Vegas police, and will be charged with DUI resulting in death, which is a Class B felony in Nevada. A conviction on the offense might result in a jail term ranging from 2 to 20 years. He is also charged with careless driving causing death or serious bodily harm, which carries a term of 1 to 6 years in prison." According to Clark County Chief Deputy District Attorney Eric Bauman, during Ruggs' court appearance, Ruggs was traveling 156 miles per hour and had a blood alcohol level of 0.161, twice the legal limit in Nevada, prior to the incident that occurred just before 3:40 a.m., according to local CBS television station 8 News, Judge Joe Bonaventure said he could not recall a speed that high in his career, and that Ruggs' bail was set at $150,000 with an electric monitoring program and an order that he abstain from alcohol and other controlled substances. The state had requested a bail of $1 million. Tina O'Tintour of Las Vegas was the deceased victim, according to a police report acquired by the Las Vegas Review-Journal. She was 23 years old at the time. Tina Tintour's elder brother, George Tintour, claimed his family moved to Las Vegas in 2000 after fleeing war-torn Serbia, and that his parents were keeping their privacy following the horrific tragedy. Tina's dog was also killed, he added, and his sister was driving home from a dog park at the time of the accident. Ruggs' girlfriend, Kiara Janai Kilgo Washington, who goes by the name Rudy Washington, was the female passenger in the car with him, per the Review Journal, and suffered a wrist injury as well. So what is Henry Ruggs' status with the NFL? The league released a statement on Tuesday. "Our hearts go out to the family and friends of the victim of this horrific tragedy. We will continue to gather facts and monitor the matter under our policies, but our thoughts at this time are with those impacted by this devastating incident." Ruggs is currently a free agent after being released by the Raiders. He may sign with any of the other 31 clubs. Under the NFL's personal conduct and substance abuse standards, he may be placed on the commissioner's exempt list. So, how important was Henry Ruggs to the Raiders? Ruggs, a 2020 first-round selection, 12th overall, led the club in receiving yards this season with 469. With an average of 19.5 yards per reception, he was the Raiders' premier deep threat and scored twice. How have Henry Ruggs' former teammates and coaches responded? Nick Saban, Ruggs' coach at Alabama, shared his condolences with the victim's family, but also said he supports Ruggs and his family. "These consequences are going to be pretty devastating to Henry," Saban added. "We love him. We're going to support him through it, but we also have a lot of compassion for the victims, and our thoughts and prayers are also with them." Interim coach Rich Bisaccia and quarterback Derek Carr also expressed sadness for the victim's family and Ruggs. "We love Henry Ruggs and want him to know that," Bisaccia said. "It's a terrible lapse in terrific kind. It's something that he will have to live with the rest of his life. The gravity of the situation is not lost on anyone here, and we understand and respect the loss of life." But anyways guys, that's it for today. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure you guys do go ahead and hit that like button. Also, don't forget to subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you never miss out on any future content we'll produce for you guys. We're signing off for now, but we'll be sure to catch you all in the next one.